attention.
L'honorable député de Laurier-Sainte-Marie.
Merci beaucoup, Madame la Présidente. Madame la Présidente, pendant des semaines, que dis-je, pas des semaines, des mois, le ministre des Affaires étrangères et le premier ministre nous ont dit que la question de la vente d'armes à l'Arabie saoudite était un « done deal », que c'était une affaire faite, que c'était une affaire réglée qui avait été faite par les conservateurs. Et à un moment donné, en avril, on a appris que c'était le ministre lui-même qui, moi-même, à ce moment-là, avait signé les permis d'exportation pour ces armes qui s'en vont en Arabie saoudite. Yes, indeed, Madam Speaker, it's the current foreign minister who signed the export license for the Saudi arm deal. And they had said for a long time that that deal was a done deal. So there's two explanations to that. It's either that the minister and the prime minister actually misled Canadians on such an important issue, or that they consider that export licenses are a formality, that, you know, it's not really important, that as soon as the sale deal is signed, who cares about the export licenses? And they did an assessment, but they did a very, very weak assessment, because they have to do an assessment before of the potential for use to commit abuse against human rights before granting an export permit. But the assessment is so weak, so it doesn't respect at all our rules, our regulations, our international commitment. Let me quote some experts from civil society about that assessment. They say, quote, the Minister of Foreign Affairs has stated that Canada has no evidence that Saudi Arabia has used Canadian-made goods against civilians. However, the threshold established by Canadian export controls to assess the possibility of misuse is neither evidence nor certainty, but reasonable risk. Given what is known about Saudi Arabia's abysmal and worsening human rights record, both within Saudi Arabia and in neighboring Yemen, we consider this risk to be evident. Et je suis tout à fait d'accord avec ces experts. On a vu ce que l'Arabie saoudite a fait au Yémen, fait contre sa propre population, en utilisant des blindés semblables à ceux qu'on va leur vendre. En fait, les libéraux semblent avoir signé ces permis d'exportation les yeux fermés. Le premier ministre dit que d'avoir annulé la vente aurait nuit à la réputation du Canada. D'abord, on n'aurait pas annulé la vente. La vente n'est pas complète tant que les permis ne sont pas livrés. Et en plus, je pense, moi, que ce qui nuit vraiment à notre réputation, c'est pas respecter nos propres règles et nos engagements. Alors, ça soulève d'autres questions, d'ailleurs. Pourquoi est-ce que le ministre a signé? Why did the minister sign for 70% of the deal, which is supposed to go over 14 years? Is it because he's afraid once Canada accedes to the ATT, as he has promised, that they won't be, Canada won't be able to play with the rules like that and to lack transparency as it has done in this case?
Honourable Parliamentary Secretary to the Minister of Foreign Affairs.
Thank you very much, Madam Speaker. I'm pleased for the opportunity to be absolutely clear on this export deal. This deal was signed by the previous government. It is a deal that this government, during the electoral campaign, committed to upholding. It is a deal which, during the electoral campaign, both major oppositions also committed to upholding. This government is honouring the deal because it has a duty to protect the value of Canada's reputation and signature as a global trading partner. This government is honouring this deal because it takes its duty to protect 3,000 jobs in London, Ontario, and across Canada seriously. This government is honouring this deal because cancelled contracts result in financial penalties for Canadian taxpayers. This government is also honouring this deal, and this is something important to understand. Saudi Arabia is a strategic partner in an increasingly volatile region and an essential partner in preventing the chaos, lawlessness, atrocities, and terrorist attacks perpetuated by ISIL, Al-Qaeda, and other terrorist groups active in the region and beyond. Having made the decision to not overturn the contract signed under the previous government, the Minister of Foreign Affairs then had the responsibility to determine whether it was appropriate to authorize export permits. The Minister made his decision because he was satisfied that the equipment will be used in a manner consistent with Saudi Arabia's role as a strategic partner and taking into account an assessment based on the fact that for 20 years this equipment has been sold to Saudi Arabia and that all checks to date indicate the equipment has not been used contrary to its intended purpose or to commit human rights violations. However, as with all export permits, the Minister of Foreign Affairs retains the power to revoke the permits at any time, should the government's assessment change. And the Minister has committed to exercising this responsibility with the greatest rigour and transparency. Do we agree with Saudi Arabia's human rights record? Not in the least. That is why we are committed to continue to make use of every opportunity to engage our Saudi counterparts, to raise concerns and to work towards advancing human rights. As the Minister of Foreign Affairs did directly with his Saudi counterpart in December and again in Jeddah in May when he met with senior officials, including the President of Saudi Human Rights Commission. This approach to Saudi Arabia is also the same as that of our allies, which stands Canada in good stead. Madam Speaker, this government has committed to developing measures to further enhance transparency in the export controls process. And this government is proud to be acceding to the United Nations, to the Arms Trade Treaty. And this government is keeping its word by doing exactly what it and both parties opposite said they would do during the campaign by honouring the contract and by granting the export permit. Thank you.
L'honorable député de Laurier-Sainte-Marie.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. It's rather troubling, not only a bit, it's quite troubling, because the government says that it is committed to upholding the contract, but at the same time, they say they can cancel it anytime. I'm not sure I see the logic into that. Unless, of course, nothing would have happened up to now. But I'm sorry, we have evidence of violations of international law in Yemen, yet the foreign minister says that it's good because Saudi Arabia, I'm talking of violations of international law by Saudi Arabia, and the minister says, oh, it's good because Saudi Arabia will be able to use those arms there. So I fail to see the logic. And as for the fight,
je m'excuse. Je m'excuse, le temps est écoulé pour vous. Alors, la ministre, la secrétaire parlementaire a la chance de faire une réplique. The Honourable Parliamentary Secretary.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. The Government of Canada, as we said we would, is upholding an already signed commercial contract in the interests of Canada's international reputation, security and economy. We assessed the human rights implications of this deal. We made the decision to honour the already signed contract. The Minister of Foreign Affairs granted the export permits based on an assessment that the export was consistent with Canadian foreign, defence and security interests, including human rights. Madam Speaker, the government is committed to restoring Canada's role as a constructive actor on the world stage and to continue to pursue global security and stability. One component of this will be Canada's accession to the Arms Trade Treaty, which will take place at the earliest opportunity. This is yet one more demonstration of our government's commitment to transparency, to rigorous export permits, and vigilance with respect to human rights. Thank you.